Since I was a child, I've always wanted to visit Australia because of the Great Barrier Reef and to see the corals. It's always fascinated me. In fact, one of the first things I learned about corals was that they aren't rocks. Yes, they aren't. At first glance, you may think that coral reefs are made up of rocks. But actually, they are living organisms. These organisms are tiny little animals called polyps. Polyps live on the outside of the reef. As polyps die, they become hard and new polyps grow on top of them, causing the reef to grow. In fact, the Great Barrier Reef in Australia stretches out to almost 2,600 miles. Besides being beautiful, a tourist attraction, and an important part of planet Earth, coral reefs have a positive impact on many people throughout the world. This includes food from fishing, protection of coastlines from erosion, and even medical discoveries such as medicines for cancer. They provide a natural habitat and protection for different species of fish. And when they all come together, they help to form a home for these fish. Without them, fishes in the oceans are homeless. The sun is the source of energy for the coral reef ecosystem. Plant plankton, called phytoplankton, algae, and other plants convert light energy into chemical energy through photosynthesis. Algae and seagrasses are the main types of plants in the coral reef ecosystem. These plants give food and oxygen to the animals that live on the reef. Seagrasses are especially important because they provide shelter for juvenile reef animals like conch and lobster. Different types of coral grow into different shapes. Some look like mushrooms, some trees, fans, honeycombs, flowers, and even brains. All sorts of animals live around a coral reef. This includes many different types of corals, such as star coral, brain coral, column coral, cactus coral, and finger coral. Many animals attach themselves to the reef, covering nearly every square inch. They include sponges, starfish, anemones, cucumbers, snails, and clams. Although there are lots of fish swimming around, such as cuttlefish, sharks, lionfish, pufferfish, clownfish, and eels, in the Great Barrier Reef alone, there are 1,500 species of fish and 400 species of coral that live there. But all this beauty is being destroyed. It is estimated that we have already lost 10% of the world's reefs. And scientists say that in the next 50 years, many of the coral reefs on Earth will be gone. This destruction is often connected with human activity. Pollution, sewage, erosion, irresponsible fishing, poor tourism practices, and global warming. And corals take a very long time to form. In fact, in our lifetime, we might not be able to see this happen. Because large reefs grow at the rate of 1 to 2 centimeters per year. It's estimated that some of the largest reefs took as long as 30 million years to form. And when they grow, they become gigantic. In fact, the Great Barrier Reef is so big, it can be seen from outer space. So preserve these corals, because otherwise, our future generation might never be able to see them.